Wonderful. Our small screen looks pretty good, apart from those borders, which of course we'll remove a little bit later. So now let's focus on the multiple screen sizes. And of course, we'll do that setting up the media queries. So let me go here with media screen, and I believe we'll have three of them. So I'll right away set them up, and then we'll just worry about the code inside of them. So let's just go with 576 pixels. And then we want to copy and paste this one two times. And then as far as the values, one is going to be for 992. And then the last one will be for 1200 pixels. So we set this one up. And then inside of the first one, we want to go with recipes list. So this is the actual list where we have the cards. Keep that in mind. I'm not talking about the container. I'm talking about the recipes list where we have the cards. And I want to set it up as two column layout. So let's go over here with recipes list. And then we want to go with grid template columns. And we'll set it up as one fraction and one fraction. Now keep in mind that if we scroll up, and if we take a look at the recipes list, it is already a display grid, correct? So therefore, I can right away set up that column layout. And I also like to set up my images a little bit smaller once they're side by side. So on a small screen, I mean, 15 REMs is pretty good. But once actually the screen size gets a little bit bigger, meaning starting with 576, and once I have the two column layout, actually makes a little bit more sense to go with a recipe and then IMG, at least in my opinion. Of course, you don't have to, but at least in my opinion, I always go with 10 REMs. Basically, I set them smaller, maybe sometimes bigger than 10 REMs, and hopefully you get the gist. So now let me navigate here to the big screen just to showcase what's happening. So I'll make this one on over here. So this is going to be our one column layout. And then once we get to the 576, of course, this is going to be the look. So now we have that two column layout. Hopefully that is clear. And now we can focus on 992. Now at 992, we'll actually change the layout for the entire container where we have the tags as well as this recipes list. And the way we'll do that, of course, we'll look for our media query. That's step number one. And we're looking for recipes and container. Now again, it is already display grid, correct? Starting with the small screen. So the only thing we really need to do is come up with values for the columns. And in my case, I went with 200 pixels. So that's for the tags. That's the width of my first column. And then one fraction, basically to take up the remaining space for the recipes list. And as far as the recipes list, well, I have already a grid template column set to one fraction, one fraction. So I don't need to worry about that. The only thing that I want to set up here, and maybe I'll style the paragraph a little bit differently as well, but as far as the tags container, I want to go with order and zero. Remember, on a small screen, what was the order? It was one. And what was the result? Well, the result was that tags are all the way in the bottom, correct? So they're after the recipes list. Now, of course, once we get to 992, I want this look. I want actually both of them side by side like this. So I need to place it back where it belongs. And of course, I can do that with order of zero. So let's go with tags and then a list. Let's set up, or I'm sorry, not tags list. My bad. So tags container first, and we'll go with order. And of course, it's going to be zero. And then as far as the tags list, of course, we have three column layout on a small screen. But is that something we want over here? Of course, no. We want one column layout, because now, of course, they will be side by side. Now, how we can achieve that? Well, we can go to tags list. And remember, it is already display grid. It already has the column layouts. We simply need to change it. We need to go with grid template columns and set it up as one fraction. And lastly, as far as the recipe, I actually want to go with paragraph font size to be 0.85 REMs. So you can place it at the very end or after the recipe. It doesn't really matter. We'll go with recipe paragraph. And let's just go with font size. And like I said, we're going to be looking for 0.5 REMs. Let's save it. And let's take a look. And we can clearly see that this is our main container with a red border. And then, of course, I have blue border for the recipes, meaning for the tags, I'm sorry. And then the green one for recipes. And as you can see, once we have a smaller screen, then, of course, we have this layout. And once we get over here, beautiful. Now we have two column layout. And lastly, once we get to 1200 pixels, the only thing I really want to do here is make the recipes list a three column layout. So let me swing back and we'll keep on scrolling. And of course, at 1200 pixels, we'll set up our recipes list to be a grid template columns. And of course, I'm looking for three column layouts. So I'm going to go with one fraction, and one fraction. And yes, I'm fully aware that, of course, we can write the repeat and all that. But in this case, I just thought that it's going to be quicker if I go with one fraction. And then as far as the font size for the heading 5, I want to set it up to be 1.15 REMs. So I'm looking for a recipe. And since I already have for the paragraph, I might as well copy and paste. And essentially, we want to go with heading 5 here. I believe it was heading 5. And then we'll go with 1.15 REMs. Let's save that one. And I need to navigate back to the homepage here. And now let's take a look at our big screen layout. So essentially, once our screen gets bigger, 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 then of course, we arrive at the three column layout. Again, this is going to be the look on a small screen where we have recipes list first, then we have the tags. Then once we get to the 576, we have two column layout for the recipes list. Then once we get to 992, we have two column layout for the entire container. And we still have these two columns over here for the recipes list. And then once we get to the big screen, voila. Of course, now we have two column layout and here we have three column layout. So now, of course, the only thing really left is to remove those borders. So we have recipes list, we have tags container, and of course we have the recipes container. And with this in place, we have tackled the big beast. Congratulations. And now, of course, we can move on to our next step.